Hello guys, welcome back. This is your boy here, Adam Sling. I hope you guys are doing okay. This is my new channel, Ninja Boy. Please support me here as well. Like this video, comment, share it on social media platform. Follow me on Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, Adam Sling Media. Make sure you subscribe and click the bell notification to get updates anytime, any day I upload. So the other day I went to the market and I informed you guys that I have bought Samsung Ultra 21. A really, really good phone. But I'm going to tell you why I regret buying this phone personally. So stay tuned. Firstly, I told you this phone cost me the sum of 700,000 naira. So I'm going to break it down a little bit for you. This phone plus this is 700,000 naira. Depending on the gig, you won't get this phone in Nigeria market from 550, so 600,000 naira. So I got mine for 570,000 naira because of the gig. And of course, this for this iPod, it's 700,000 naira. Yeah, guys, I know I was cheated by this market. I was cheated. I know that. I bought it later. I knew that, yeah, I was actually cheated. But ordinarily, you can get this phone for 550. Then this iPod for 70,000 to 80,000 naira. So you really need to go to Nigerian market to price very well. You know, we love pricing in Nigerian market. So the reason why I decided to buy this phone, firstly, it was because of the review I saw on YouTube. I don't know, it seems those reviewers on YouTube are getting paid money to review phones. And when they review phones, they don't tell us the entire truth about a phone. So I saw this perfect review of this phone. That's what led me to buy this phone. Honestly, I was using iPhone 11 Pro Max. This was a gift from me from my viewer on Adam Kling Media. And the reason why this phone wasn't enough for me, the camera quality is good, can shoot on 4K. But the reason why it wasn't enough for me because of the space. 64 gig of space. It doesn't allow me to shoot on 4K because 4K takes a lot of space, and I have my own personal pictures as well on this phone, so it wasn't really that durable for me. So that's why I hope to buy this phone. Of course, I would have gone to buy an iPhone 12 with much more, like 500 something gig, which would be enough. Also, I have a laptop, HP laptop, that is slightly also expensive as well. I have an HP laptop that I would love to be transferring pictures directly to the laptop, but using an iPhone is almost impossible for you to transfer pictures, videos from here to any other system apart from an Apple laptop. Is extremely hard, except when you get a third party. Well, yeah, I have a third party, sometimes it does fail. So I was going back and forth worrying about in getting going back and forth, worrying about him not able to transfer some time. So that is why I said, okay, let me just go for this phone. Since the camera quality is slightly better than iPhone 11 Pro Max, and they add a lot of space, and of course, I can do all my Adam Sling vlog on this. That is the reason why I bought this phone. Plus the review that I saw on YouTube. But I'm going to tell you this now. This I might be saving someone from buying this phone. If you are a vlogger, then you should watch it. But if you just want to buy a phone that will allow you to take pictures, beautiful pictures, and just not really use the phone most of the time, then I will advise you, you can go for this phone. It's good for you. But for people like me, no, I won't go for this phone. But I already have it, so there's nothing I can do, so I will still be using it. So let's go down into the reason why I regret buying this phone. Firstly, overeating. We're in Nigeria, we're in Africa, and we are a little bit closer to the sun. And here there is high temperature. Even afternoon, you living in Nigeria can tell that yes, it's really, really hot. Mainly in the afternoon, so it tends to overeat. When you put them in the same temperature, This phone 11 Pro Max can withstand it longer than this. Sometimes the camera won't work. Sometimes it will tell you it is shutting down. Sometimes none of the app will work. It will tell you it's overheating. Meanwhile, on the same in the same temperature, this one is working fine and good. Everything is okay. Why this one? In just a little while, this phone will be so hot when you even touch the back. It might even burn your skin. So I don't know why. It seems like Samsung made this phone for people living in high sea area, very, very low temperature, because I don't understand why the heat in Nigeria will make this phone malfunction. It's not as if I'm putting it inside an oven. No, I'm just trolling. If my skin can withstand the heat, what stops this phone from withstanding the same heat? That's the craziness of this phone. And also, when you want to take pictures, Samsung is better when there's lighting. There's this high everywhere is outside. Samsung is better outdoor where there's this lighting. But in low light, I give it to iPhone 11 Pro Max. I've tried it, guys. I give it to iPhone 11 Pro Max. But when you are outside, I will give it to Samsung. Samsung is way better with lighting. Way better. You're going to enjoy using Samsung. And when you are this type that love to face chat, to video call, I will tell you honestly, go for this phone. This phone will give you some serious cute filter that a iPhone can't give you. This phone has it all. When you are this social media freak and you want to take good pictures and you want to look good on FaceTime, go for Samsung. But beware of the overheating. And reasons I regret buying this phone is the battery life. I recently bought this phone. This phone is new. But how come the battery life of this phone lasts longer than this? And it's not fake. It's not fake. 2 years warranty. How come the battery of this 11 Pro Max, not even 12 Pro Max, not even iPhone 13 that's yet to come out, how come the 11 Pro Max battery lasts longer than this Samsung? Yeah, that is a crazy thought. So, and apart from that, let's talk about the Wi-Fi. The Wi-Fi on this phone is great. The strength is great. And also, for example, my 11 Pro Max, when I use MTN, I usually use Etisalat and MTN, and in this my room, the network in this my room is a little bit slow when using this. When I put the SIM card, my MTN or Etisalat here is a little bit slower than this. This phone, when I put same SIM card, the MTN SIM card that give me 3G on this phone, currently it's on 3G. This phone, when I put it here, this phone will give me light or 4G. So that is different. So this phone with Wi-Fi, this phone is slightly better than this. Then with browser, me, I'm a vlogger and I deal on YouTube, and when I want to upload my video, it's like 20 minutes long video. And honestly, when I'm uploading on YouTube with this phone, using Chrome is a little bit slower than this. iPhone has an app, Safari, and honestly, up to today, I don't see any other browser that is better than Safari when it comes to speed. So when I upload my YouTube videos here, it's slightly slower than this. This one is faster with Safari than this. Maybe it's because of iPhone Safari is way stronger than normal Chrome. So maybe that's the reason why. And accessibility, this phone, and accessibility, yeah, I give it to this phone. You know, in Nigeria, we mostly don't use Apple laptop. What we mainly use is HP and other laptop, which is very, very easy for them to access this phone. If Apple laptop can just allow, or Apple can allow their phone to be accessed by other computers, I think that would be so, so better. I think we're going to open their market a little bit further. But you know, they are slightly not into, they do not like to share their stuff. So they are still very, very secretive and very personal when it comes to that. So guys, meanwhile, the only thing that really throws me off with this phone is the browser and the heat. Come on, I'm in Nigeria. There's always heat. There's no way I can cool off or turn off the air condition from the heavens that will automatically change the weather in Nigeria. If my skin, I believe if my skin can withstand any heat in Nigeria, a phone should be able to withstand it as well. And when you see, when you are in the same when they are in the same temperature, you can see the fan, you can hear the fan working, the cooling system here working, you can hear the noise, making that humming noise. Why this one? You don't even hear anything. It seems like there's no even air condition in this. And every phone should have some kind of a cooling system inside it. And it seems this Samsung Ultra doesn't have it. And you know, when you overheat today, also overheat tomorrow, overheat next tomorrow, every day continuously overheating, I'm telling you, it will be slowly developing faults. That is my fear. Now it's still very, very good, but it will be slowly developing faults. I can't shoot a complete movie or a complete vlog outside with this phone. It will definitely overheat, but I can do that with this. So honestly, that throws me off. Really, really, really throws me off. I don't care about the 8K. I don't care about the 4K. I care about this thing lasting long because I spent so much money on it. So for those of you, my final review is that if you are a vlogger and you want to be doing outdoor vlogging or editing outside or want to do something in this temperature in Africa, please think twice before buying this. But if you are just a normal person who just want to take pictures and just leave your, no, you know, you are not really, really into the phone that much, then Samsung is a better phone for you. So don't just try it out. I'm telling you the truth. That is the honest truth. So guys, so thank you very much for watching. It's the boy Iggy Adams link on this my channel, Ninja Boy. Stay tuned. Make sure you share this this video with someone else. And thank you very much for watching. Have a wonderful day. Bye.